Good evening. We begin with breaking news. The southeast is right now being smashed by snap summer storms. Power is out to tens of thousands. Homes and cars have been damaged, and wind gusts akin to a Category 4 cyclone are capping off a day of intense heat.
Dizzying heat followed by thundering storms. This isn't your typical summer day in Queensland. Damaging winds, rain and hail smashing the southeast. Trees falling in Brookwater, destroying a car, narrowly avoiding houses. Nearby at Augustine Heights, massive trees are blocking roads. In Springfield, hail blanketed front yards. As winds whipped through Brisbane's CBD, gusts of 169 kilometres an hour recorded at Archerfield Airport. Southern suburbs like Forest Lake, Annerley and Moorooka also smashed. This high-rise rooftop pool looking more like a wave break. While balcony furniture went flying through the air at South Brisbane. On the Gold Coast, more destruction. Power lines down, at least 17,000 homes across the southeast tonight in the dark. The wild storms ending a day of stifling heat. Queenslanders making the most of the calm before the storm.
We ate ice cream and then I go to the pool.
The severe heatwave set to last the weekend.
We're looking at both daytime temperatures and overnight mins being ranging anywhere from 3 to 5 or 6 degrees above average.
Given that, we're expecting an increase in demand and a very busy weekend. We're asking Queenslanders to stay cool, stay safe.
But the lingering heat means more thunderstorms are likely on the way.
Thunderstorm activity is likely to be a focal point in the southeast from today and over the weekend. And
Meg Sides, Nine News.
Let's go straight to weather expert Luke Bradnam at Surfers Paradise. Luke, what areas are being impacted tonight?
Well, Melissa, this system is massive. It's not just a severe thunderstorm warning for us in the southeast, but it's stretching right the way through Wide Bay, Burnett, up towards the Capricornia coast. I'll show you the radar, and you can see it's just relentless. As one wave moves off the coast, it's replaced by another, moving from the southwest in a northeasterly direction. At the moment, we're seeing areas around Camp Hill and certainly most of the south of the city being affected. But wait your turn. If it's not raining at the moment, it will be in the couple of hours to come. This system has been brewed today, Melissa, by the humidity and the heat. The real concern for us is tomorrow is set to be even warmer and more humid. More severe storms possible tomorrow. I'll have all the details of full weather app coming up a little later.
Talk to you then. Thanks, Luke. Thousands of homes and businesses in far north Queensland are likely to be without power until next week, with flooded roads and fallen trees making it difficult to access a number of areas. Nine News managed to reach some isolated communities to speak to residents who've been unable to contact loved ones for days.
North of Port Douglas, in this quiet enclave of Wonga Beach, 88-year-old Brian Cornell has been waiting in agony.
You've been stuck here now for what, about at least 3 days?
Yes, and under worse circumstances that I could imagine. Normally, you know, I'm about and fit, but at the moment, hurt my back nearly a couple of weeks ago.
His back seized up as the cyclone hit. He can barely move his generator and care for his wife. His home is swamped.
But there's nothing I can do. I think all the medical services would probably be closed, and we can't get into Mossman. So I just got to sit it out with Panadol.
Wonga has been isolated for days. Like other areas north of Mossman, power lines and trees are down, the roads in and out keep going under, and the communications are shot. Bev Gwynn, who lives next door, has been helping where she can, but like the rest of this community, she's stuck here too.
And having no power and internet's been, well, the power we can deal with, it's just hard with the internet. People are worried, you know, what's going on.
Further south at Machin's Beach near Cairns, a Nine camera caught neighbours rushing to help Jeff, who became stuck in fast rising water.
They said the SES were coming to get him out, so we headed back, went for breakfast, come back again. Apparently he's still here, so just drove down, pulled him out. Well, we just come down to have a look at the floodwaters, and my mate's one of the blokes at the front there, and he's someone was stuck here. He was a bit shocked, he was hoping this high tide wouldn't get up and take him off.
The Daintree remains under major flood watch tonight. Falls of more than 250 millimetres are still possible for the next 24 hours across the region, on top of an already swamped far north. Of the 43,000 homes and businesses who lost power in the cyclone on Wednesday night, 15,000 were still without power today.
We're aiming to have the vast majority on board tomorrow night is what we're aiming for, but the rest may stretch out to about Tuesday, depending on the conditions, if it's safe to access some of the areas.
When you're dealing with this kind of weather, it's no wonder it'll take a bit of time to get everyone back online. Authorities are hoping electricity, communications, internet and FPOS will be up and running by Tuesday.
Straight to Josh Bavis near Mossman. Josh, you've just seen another emergency play out there.
Melissa, the rain is coming down very heavy here, just on the northern side of Mossman. Now, we understand there is a medical emergency and crews are trying to get someone to the other side to safety. Now, this area, we're able to come to you via a satellite, but for everybody else, there's no power, there's no telephone, there's no internet. I even struggle to understand how, if someone needed an emergency crew, how they'd even make that telephone call. The rain here, we're expecting at least another 200 millimetres. Melissa, we hope that it will stop and ease to give these communities a reprieve.
Yes, we do, Josh. Thank you. Now to Cam Inglis in Cairns. Cam, more help is on the way for the far north.
Yeah, Melissa, reinforcements are arriving. Another 45 State Emergency Service volunteers landing here in Cairns today. They will be helping existing crews who really have done a remarkable job. And while this cyclone didn't have the widespread damage that was first forecast, it is quite it remains damaged in pockets. And really, it's only going to be once this heavy rain stops and these floodwaters recede that this massive cleanup job can really begin. Melissa.
Thank you, Cam.